house and build it up again. Tell them I burned it down twice just for the fun of it. So much money, I don't know what to do with it. Tell them I don't pick up my phone, ain't knowing what the time. Tell them I got me one gun and an alibi.
All right, coming up next, this highly anticipated matchup for the UFC middleweight division title.
Ready.
Crowd getting excited as this fight gets underway, and he nice defense there, huge block. Oh, big knee to the body. How'd he get that one home? And he landed the right hand there.
Let's get going now.
And he comes through with a big knee.
Jab hurt him a little bit.
Oh! All right, so he continues to use his jab effectively here, DC. He gets that hand to the target pretty quick.
I mean, just right away, blasting the jab after jab after jab. He's a phenomenal boxer with a vast understanding of fighting behind an educated jab. Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
So just over 20 total strikes have now landed for the last style bender, Israel Adesanya.
Look at the whip action that comes from him throwing that kick.
Well, he's doing a nice job here blocking these shots. The chin is tucked, the hands are high. Pretty good job defensively thus far.
Great job defensively. He's seeing everything coming. Real quick leg kick. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one up?
Trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position up the bottom.
Well, working pretty effectively from the top here. Nice ground and pound by Adesanya. Close guard. Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head or he's going to get blasted. He's going to start looking to try to attack a rear naked choke, and that's exactly what he's doing. He is doing a really good job of relaxing, not panicking, because he's getting choked. Oh, he might have got him with a choke.
Wow. Ooh, right into side control, DC.
This is where you want to be now, because you get to make your opponent decide. They try to turn back into you, you can attack guillotine. If they turn away to try to get to your knees, you throw your hooks in, and you got all your rear choke submissions.
All right, let's now look back at some of the action from that round. He went headhunting, landed, nearly got the finish, too.
A lot of coaches tell you don't headhunt. In this case, he's been headhunting, and he landed a big enough shot to truly put his opponent on notice.
All right, round two.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Oh, he's off the score. How's his opponent? opponent still stand?
I mean, I have no idea. This fight is supposed to be over. And it might not be over now, but it's gonna be over very soon.
He missed with that jab attempt there. Oh, looks like he's trying to set up the takedown. There's the attempt.
Great punch. You don't know when that leg kick's coming.
Oh, effective use of the jab by Adesanya. Oh, beautiful land there by Adesanya. You hear this crowd just eating out of his hand, oohing and aahing every time he advances.
I mean, he just captures your imagination from the walkout to the entrance when he's in the octagon, the fighting style. He just kind of has that thing that makes you want to stop and stare at Israel Adesanya.
Nice punch by Adesanya. Well, DC, headgear's not allowed, but he has raised the hands, and he's doing a nice job protecting the dome.
He's doing a great job of blocking his head.
Oh, good strike lands there, and somehow his opponent's chin held up.
His opponent's chin held up, but you do not want to be on the receiving end of those types of strikes. Now he's on top of him looking for a finish.
Pretty significant. Well, on the left side. Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do.
He's going to start looking to land big shots from the top.
All right, side control now. All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. Beautiful movement, hip work on the ground here. Just outstanding with the transition.
He is not staying in one place on the ground, and that's very important.
Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. All right, he's in a half-guard position here, DC, and in a good spot to dole out a lot of damage, I would think. A
lot of damage can be done from the half-guard. You sit back on that leg, you press down into your opponent, you drop elbows, you drop punches. What is very key is you controlling the underhook on the far side. If you give up that underhook, your opponent can use the half guard to build up to an elbow, sweep, or just chase down a single leg.
10 seconds. Nicely done there as he forces the miss from his opponent. Why, so there is the horn at times in that previous round. I didn't think we'd get here after that head kick nearly had him out of there.
It was a good round leading up to that. But when you take a head kick like that, when your opponent gets your entire body into that kick, usually the night's over. Very tough to still be standing, but he can't take many more like that.
Defense by Israel.
Oh, lands another beautiful strike to the body, really starting to connect at will when it comes to working the body, and especially effective doing it later in this fight. See a lot of that from him in the earlier rounds. Oh, can't do that in soccer, but it's allowed here. Nice trip to get the takedown.
Oh, great foot sweep right there. Got to the clinch, started manipulating the body, and the moment his opponent took a misstep, boom, tripped him right over the top. Great job.
Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. Man, isn't it fun to watch this dude work on the mat?
He's unbelievable how fluid he is in his motions on the mat.
Sound strike on the ground. All right, working inside the closed guard now. Man, this is some serious ground and pound here, DC. He's not just staying busy for the sake of staying busy. These strikes are doing damage.
Oh, yeah, no pity pat to this guy. This guy's trying to land, and he's trying to land effective strikes.
All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
Side control now, DC. A lot of options at his disposal from here. All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent. You got to be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. All right, operating inside the closed guard now. Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
Adesanya's back in half guard. He's very comfortable here. All right, DC, half guard position here. You've done a lot of good work in this spot in your career.
Oh, man, I love this position. And you see this fighter today loves it, too. It is the most secure position in fighting. You get an underhook on one side, you keep a half guard on the other, and then you just go to work. It's the safest position, especially for a wrestler.
Oh, he postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now the ground and pound starts.
Well, the ground and pound is there once again. Strong work here by Adesanya. 1 minute remains in the fight. All right, he continues to bully his opponent here, really manhandling him on the ground. Back to the feet now. Just an absolutely gorgeous shot to spell the end for his opponent. Crowd is absolutely loving it. He gets the near-perfect land. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming, but just the way he drew it up here tonight, saw that little crack of an opening and barged right through it to get the knockout. Well, another highlight for the real DC as we look back at that scintillating knockout.
Yeah, but the whole fight, he was landing great strikes, kicks, punches. He was doing everything right until eventually he found the shot that ended the fight.
Now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is going to stop for this contest at 4 minutes, 32 seconds of round number 3. Declaring the winner by knockout and new UFC middleweight champion of the world, Israel.
So how about this, DC? We have a new UFC middleweight champion, and in this era of the 185ers, this division has never been stronger. They're all chasing a new man tonight.
One of the toughest divisions in the entire UFC, and right now, he sits atop it. Congratulations to a fantastic fighter.